Inflammation is fundamentally a protective response of the body against any offending agent or tissue damage. It involves responses of the vascular tissues, leukocytes, mast cells, and macrophages, which help in getting rid of the cause of tissue injury or insult. So how is an inflammatory response triggered? Well, microbes, necrotic cells, or tissue injury could trigger the release of certain soluble factors from inflammatory cells, endothelial cells, or from plasma. Now, these soluble factors are called mediators of inflammation, and they initiate and amplify the inflammatory response and determine the consequent clinical and pathologic manifestations. Mediators of inflammation are either cell-derived or derived from plasma proteins. When derived from cells, they could either be preformed, meaning they could already exist in the cell, or could be newly synthesized. So let's understand this better. Cells like mast cells, for example, have intracellular granules packed with chemical mediators called histamine. Mast cells, when stimulated, degranulate and release these already preformed chemical mediators, eliciting inflammation. On the other hand, there are certain chemical mediators like prostaglandins or leukotrienes that are not preformed. They don't exist in granules. They are rather newly synthesized in the cell with the help of certain enzymes when needed. Leukocytes, mast cells, macrophages, platelets, and even endothelial cells could synthesize mediators of inflammation. Cell-derived preformed mediators of inflammation are histamine and serotonin. Now, these factors are packed in granules of mast cells and platelets. Most of the factors are newly synthesized and consist of various chemical mediators ranging from eicosanoids like prostaglandins and leukotrienes, pro-inflammatory cytokines like interleukin-1 and tumor necrosis factor alpha, chemokines, platelet activating factor, and even free radicals like reactive oxygen species. Those factors that are plasma-derived are proteins that are inactive in the circulation. These proteins could be stimulated by various factors and be activated, which then could trigger a cascade of reactions. Plasma-derived mediators are usually complement proteins C3A, C4A, and C5A, kinins, and proteases activated during coagulation. Now, before we get into the details of these mediators of inflammation, let's get to know some of their properties. Chemical mediators of inflammation are only stimulated by factors like microbes, foreign agents, damaged and necrotic tissue. Usually these are factors or molecules that can trigger inflammation through various receptors and other pathways. This way, there is always a check to which molecules trigger inflammation. A chemical mediator could stimulate the production or release of another mediator. A common example would be pro-inflammatory cytokine tumor necrosis factor alpha acting on the endothelium, which in turn produces cytokine interleukin-1. Also, complement proteins like C3A and C5A could stimulate mast cells to degranulate and release histamine. Different chemical mediators could share the same function, and any one chemical mediator could have more than one function. Mediators like histamine, serotonin, and leukotrienes could all cause an increased vascular permeability of the blood vessels. Also, complement proteins like C3A, C5A, and leukotriene B4 are chemotactic factors that help recruit neutrophils to the site of inflammation. Different mediators sharing the same function. Complement proteins like C3A and C5A, besides being anaphylotoxins stimulating mast cell degranulation, are also chemotactic factors helping attract neutrophils to the site of inflammation, the same chemical mediators having two different functions. Most chemical mediators are short-lived, and once their function is done, they either quickly decay or are inhibited or stopped from functioning, so there's a check or balance maintained with regards to the inflammatory reactions instigated.